Good morning, Edgewater Environmental Alliance. I am at Port Orange Imaging. I am having my second mammogram to try to better identify some lesions on my right breast. And then I'm going to have a CAT scan of my abdomen to look better at my right ovary that now has masses on it. My right lung, I had a chest CAT scan and a repeat chest CAT scan, both of which came back with new nodules in the right lung. The lung, I know, has been diagnosed as toxic exposure to cyanobacteria. By the way, sorry, I'm not all made up. I don't get made up for these appointments. Anyway, toxic exposure to cyanobacteria. Yes, one of the few diagnoses in the state. I was entered into the CDC study on after effects on human health after being exposed to toxic cyanobacteria. So there's a confirmed chain of command here of my exposure and the evidence. So that's really not what we're doing. Now what we're doing is we're going through what it's like to live with toxic exposure to cyanobacteria, and do I have cancer? So this started out in my right lung and my left lung right after an exposure to cyanotoxins that were produced from multiple cyanobacteria blooms in the 18th Street Canal in Edgewater, Florida. There's a lot of information in the group. If you search PTOX, you will get a copy. You will see a copy of that actual report where the city came out and tested 2 days after my exposure. So there's a really tight chain of command on the information here. I also was working with the city on this project. At least I had their authority to do it. And they knew I was going to be on that canal that day. So, you know, they have control of this information. So you should be reaching out to the city of Edgewater and asking more questions about that. And I hope we can get some educational materials out to the community soon. But I'm going to take you on this journey with me. I should get some results of this mammogram, although I don't expect it to really tell me anything today. This is the second mammogram, which I understand has to happen before we can talk about something further. But the reason I'm bringing up the right breast and the right ovary is because on my right side, the repeat chest CT this year showed many new nodules. And at the same time, I now have new growth on my right ovary and my right breast. So I'm not blind to there's certainly something going on the right side here. And none of this started until the exposure. In fact, it started directly after in the lung. So in my mind, I'm certainly tying all of this, at least theoretically, to the exposure. There obviously are probably other things that are contributing. But in the overall thing is my mother had 14 brothers and sisters, and there were only a few cancer cases, and they were heavy smokers and had a bad lifestyle. So I have to wonder about that. My grandfather did die of cancer, but there again, heavy smoker. So there's that. My father's side, no cancer. So I think a BRCA study is going to come back negative. I'm going to do it because I need the information. And I'll let you guys know how things go and keep you coming with me. So forgive me if this is not what you want to see in here. Please just scroll on. But this is a journey that I think is important because I think many of you in Florida, in the nation, will be going through this journey. And it's kind of hard to navigate when people don't know how to diagnose or treat toxic exposure to cyanobacteria. There is no known treatment. There is no known way to remove the toxins from your body. They're cumulative. Every time I'm in the environment, which I know is toxic, I'm accumulating those toxins, which is probably why I have the additional growths. So as long as I live, I'm going to be exposed, re-exposed. Maybe we can start a little documentary called Exposed. I don't know, but anyway, I digress. Let's get on with the work, okay? Bye, guys. Love you very much. Thanks for all your support.